with the black top.
Okay, are you ready?
Malin Hermansson.
You ready?
In the yellow, referee Rich Mitchell, the third man in the cage, the only man in the cage.
So Holm has basically said that she's not going to let Hermansson box her way to a points victory. She's really going to go after her here.
Hermansson looking at the fist of Cornelia, not really giving her opponent any indication of where the headset's going to come from.
Right up through the middle, right in the cheekbone.
So there was a fair bit of criticism, and some may say successfully sorted out. Time as a pro or not, she did take a bit of flat capture. It'll be interesting to see in the second contest, are we going to see a similar kind of performance? Are we going to see more risk being taken?
Both these ladies took the full 15 minutes in their pro debuts, so, you know, a good start. The amateur competition that Cornelia Holm has done, they get a lot of fights in quick succession. You've got to be tough and resilient to go through multiple days of competition in those IWMA events.
Come
in, Malin. And in fact, I'm not sure if that's a problem with these ladies. It appears to be a bit of blood on the cage floor. I'm not sure if that's from Cornelia Holm or not. It appears it might be. A good high underhook from Holm here. She's pairing it with the head position. It's her left hand as well. It's completely free to get quick for her. Which is what she's doing here. She's kind of grinding.
Let's stay busy here, ladies.
She has to stay active. You can hear the referee, Rick Mitchell, warning her for inactivity.
It would be very interesting to see what the cause of that bleeding is. If it's the nose, is that going to affect Cornelia Holm again by actually trying to take the full distance again?
Yeah, we need to see the bleeding. Really, you know, that's how well it is. It's the nose of Cornelia Holm. I don't know if it's an elbow or a knee inside.
A clash of heads. It's a contest that's been fought in very close quarters thus far.
Very, very low in this stance. Searching as she went forward.
Caused the bleeding. And when you look at the speed of the punches from Malin Hermansson, that's put past what he didn't get to the first time round.
I mean, look, that was a really nice short right as Holm came in. Good left hook. Hermansson's starting to really find her range here on the feet.
Credit to our matchmaker Ian Dean and the Cage Warriors team for putting together this bat between two prospects.
It's almost like Hermansson is baiting for Holm to come forward, keeping her head really low and expecting to counter with a slightly faster strike.
Which legs certainly are rapid, and she's caught Holm a couple of times on the way in. Holm's had a lot of control, though, for the game. We're in that scenario, Josh, where, you know, is this effective grappling? Does this outweigh the punches that Hermansson's landed?
I mean, I know Hermansson has a lot of striking experience prior to this martial arts showing. Together, but she can't afford to spend too much time here in this position. Holm's making it easy for her.
Both Holm and Hermansson went the distance in their first bouts as professionals.
We're looking for a single now. Oh, sleeper guillotine here.
Holm looking to drop a center of gravity there. Hermansson letting her out of that guillotine.
Stop!
And all of a sudden, we get a very interesting fight in the hands, Josh.
Yeah, cracking first round for
for Hermansson when she, well, for both of them, but for Hermansson when she found her range. There's a lot of pressure from Holm, you know, when she was pushing her up against the cage and she was surging forward well, but the speed of the shots from Hermansson.
Let's take a look now at some of the action.
Oh, it's a good jab. It's a good stiff jab. I don't think I even saw that one land significantly.
Well, the hand speed is absolutely rapid, to be frank, on Hermansson. Very, very impressive.
She tried to double it up here as well, which is great. This was the pickup. Look, it's huge, but you've got to maintain the control all the way down, and she just got a little bit top heavy. And was actually on the back foot here, you know, this easy attempt initially looked really good for Hermansson.
You know, perhaps a little bit of complacency there from Holm because she's so used to throwing people around. She just didn't maintain the grip on that takedown and very nearly paid the price for it.
Yeah, I mean, look, Hermansson is the smaller fighter here, so you would expect Holm to try and bully her, try and be physical. And she is doing that, but...
slightly taller than her opponent, and certainly a little bit rangier in terms of the arm. Left landing already. You see the head dip from Holm, and immediately the left hand flicks out.
Yeah, and it's interesting because she's throwing that left hand from a real low posture.
Yeah, gunslinging there is Hermansson. I understand she's actually an avid gardener in her spare time.
See, now that was great. She slid back, and then she slipped away. It left Holm just searching with a hand out, and you know, just no power on the end of the punch from Holm because the range established by Hermansson was excellent.
Yeah, quite a serene pastime for someone who's busting heads in the cage professionally.
And what Hermansson is doing is showing a few holes in the striking of Cornelia Holm. Yeah.
There are no questions about the grappling chops of Holm, but Hermansson's certainly asking some about his striking, as you quite rightly point out, Josh.
Coach, stop! Time. You keep hitting a low. You keep hitting a low. Cut it out now. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Referee,
let's go, time in.
Calling a stop to the action there. Now, Hermansson had complained about being caught low in the first round. Referee Rich Mitchell is saying, you've done this before, cut it out now. I'm sure unintentional, but certainly something Hermansson's going to have to be thinking
about. Good footwork again, she circles out, she lands a small right hand. And it, you know, it's just funny that in her pre-fight interviews, I'm just not going to let her, you know, dance around with fancy boxing, but that's exactly what's happening here in this second round.
Well, these things often easier said than done. A nice kick up the centre line from Holm there, but didn't land. And again, caught on the way in by Hermansson. It's quite a tough style to fight against, to be honest, because you can't really shoot from too far out on the outside, because Hermansson is sweeping with the head movement and distance as opposed to firing with the hands, which means the hands are by the hips. It's not like Holm could just try and take it down because the hands are already there to block any of the takedowns. This has got to be frustrating for Cornelia Holm, it really has, because Hermansson is the one in the centre of the cage, she's the one cutting the angles, and she's landing shots with a reasonable amount of volume. The Hermansson really putting a stamp on this second round with those combination punches. Holm looking for the kick now. And what this has done, Josh, is forced Holm to open up a little bit more. And we've seen
you can see, because she's trying to tie with upper body clinches, she's really struggling to stay in on Hermansson, which is too big now. Double unders for Hermansson. Yeah.
some of the chats are on social media, and if you'd like to join in with that, use the hashtag CW93.
Defense at the moment. I think, you know, it would be a different matter if Holm was trying to hit the hips as opposed to the upper body, but there she goes down to the single leg. She's going to high crotch. We saw she can get a big pickup from here. She did it in the first round.
Just keeping the
Let's use this
on.
Position. Use this position if you want to keep it.
And already Rich Mitchell just warning.
That's really good work from Holm. It's just a shame that she's only got 13 seconds left to work, and she needed, you know, 4.5 minutes to do that. Hermansson trying to recover guard here. Get back to her feet.
Stop!
Control in the first.
Yeah, but did she do anything with it? You know, like, it's tough to say. Second round undoubtedly went to Hermansson, though. And, you know, and that's a good game plan for her. Stick to this, you know, go for the points decision. I mean, none of the shots are landing with significance enough that they're gonna spark a knockout. You don't feel like she's the fighter who's going to surge forward and flurry to finish. You know, she's counter-punching really effectively right now.
At Munch MMA on Twitter saying that Hermansson reminds them of Joanna Jędrzejczyk, just without the volume and the accuracy of those strikes. It's not a bad shout.
So, I mean, Holm, you know, she got a great takedown at the second. I'd love to see her try and get that earlier on in this round.
Hermansson there, and perhaps a little bit of urgency seeping into this one now from both ladies. Oh, nice head kick just coming with the end of the toe, though. Tries to wrap it up the other side. Hermansson pounces, though.
A great play through for Holm. Exactly what you need to do when someone scores that effectively. Pounding the legs now. And you can see Hermansson's trying to shake the knees free to allow her to get her frame back. She does it, she gets back to half guard. She's got to get on that right hip now. Again, Holm with the head. Any position gets her head involved, so they get uncomfortable.
Cornelia Holm still very much in this fight. Looking for the sweep there is Hermansson, but Holm surely will stay on top.
Yeah, and you see how quickly Holm has to press forward. She can't allow Hermansson to get back to her feet, and you really only need a split second to frame and do that.
Short punching elbows.
An open guard for Hermansson here, now to close guard.
And what does Hermansson need to do here, Joshua? Surely the game plan is to get to the feet rather than attack with a submission.
Yeah, it is. You know, feet on the hips, so deflect the head, create a frame. It's enough.
Okay, ladies, come on, you've got to get busy here. Show me something, please.
Your feet. I mean, she could hold on and hope for a passivity kind of warning, but looking for the arm here. Good head kick as well. I mean, legal in this position as well until the knees hit the ground. Over under posture for Holm, who's going to free her arm here if she can.
Not the back of her head.
The referee just warning there to target those shots.
Good shoulder pressure from Holm. You see that left shoulder rolling over. He's got a good deep grip around Hermansson's head. Hermansson's really careful. She doesn't scramble and give a back up here. You can see Holm very long in her posture on top. We're trying to get as much hip and shoulder pressure through as she
can. You
got to
progress this. Let's go. Progress.
Holm being asked for a little bit more action, a little bit of progress. Ooh, and that's good work from Hermansson. She's got back to quarter guard. You see, she's just trapped the ankle. She's got to keep fighting, though. She doesn't really give back this ground she's taken. There's a mount here for Holm if she wants it.
Hermansson rolling the dice there, and he didn't pay off. This could be exactly what Cornelia needs to get back in this fight. She's certainly going to take this round, Josh, but will it be enough?
Well, we're going to find out potentially in 50 seconds, but this is really good control. You know, it was Hermansson just trying to flurry forward and throw these really short shots around to reverse the position.
You got to use your position.
Wide heavy base, I mean, just heavy ground and pound from here. It's exactly what she needs. There's no more if she wants it. Opting for the control. I mean, maybe you just throw the submission in here to see. It's still control. It's still going to win the round.
Holm waiting for the final throws of the fight. To look something up.
Yeah, look, this is a bit of a hole for Hermansson. You see how her elbow is all the way from the body, completely exposed. You know, as she was able to show some holes in, Holm stayed with the feet. Holm was doing the same for her on the ground here, but couldn't revert to her within 9 seconds.
Stop!
Interesting one, this. Very interesting.
And in the corner of Hermansson there, look, screaming for elbows at the end, but only trying for one. Cornelia Holm raising her arms to the sky, but I would suggest that this is a far from...
Twenty-9-28 Holm, 29-28 Hermansson, and 29-28 for the winner by split decision in the blue corner, Malin Hermansson.